Hello students, how are you all? Fine? Okay, in this session we will discuss the long question, 7 marks long question of sex determination. Okay, generally you are being asked animal wise the sex determination in specific animals. Suppose you are being asked describe the chromosomal theory or chromosomal basis of sex determination in man, Drosophila, birds and honeybees. Then how we will start? First of all, you have to start with an introduction. Introduction to sex determination. Okay? So first of all, you will write down the definition of sex determination, then definition of sex, then definition of sex chromosomes, then what are the processes, steps of the sex determination. So we will start with establishment of sex through differential development in an individual at an early stage of life is called sex determination. Okay, then sex, what is sex? Biologically, sex is an aggregate of morphological, physiological and the behavioral characters that differentiate the male from a female, which differentiate the male from the female. Then you have to write down genes responsible for the sexual characters are segregated to the specific chromosomes called sex chromosomes, which are generally, you can write down, which are generally denoted by X and Y or Z and W in the diploid organisms. You can add up something, which are generally, you can write down. Then, who discovered this X and Y chromosome? Because Z and W are replaced in the place, they are the replacement of X and Y. X and Y are replaced by Z and W to prevent the confusion. But sex chromosomes in diploid organism means general, that is X and Y. Hanking in 1891 first discovered X chromosome in male bug and named it X body. Then afterward, Wilson and Stevens discovered Y chromosome. And they named the X and the two sex chromosomes as X and Y chromosome, and the rest chromosomes are they named as autosomes. Okay, but at least you can write down this much. The Hanking first discovered the X chromosome in a male bug and named it X body. Then Wilson and Stevens discovered the Y chromosome and given the chromosomal theory of sex determination. Given the chromosomal theory of sex determination. Chromosomal theory of sex determination in 1905. Okay, then sex determination and differentiation are the sequential processes that occur in the following steps. First, chromosomal sex determination by the sex chromosomes. Then gonadal sex determination by gonadal differentiation. Then phenotypic sex determination by the secretion of sex hormones from the gonads. Then the behavioral sex determination by the development of secondary sex characters. Okay, then you have to start with the animal wise. Yes, sex determination in man or human. If you are asked man or human, in human, XXXY mechanism, single gene effect. Okay, gene is the part of the chromosome. So if it is asked about chromosomal theory, then on chromosomal basis, even you will write down the single gene effect. When it is asked sex determination, simply sex determination, then he will mention this sex reversal also, because it is a hormonal. Okay, if it is asked about chromosomal only, this was. If it is asked sex determination in specific animals, then you will include this sex reversal also. Discuss XXXY mechanism. The males are heterogametic. Okay, females are homogametic. Heterogametic why? Because they produce. What is the genotype of the human being? Here only you can write down humans, that is 44 plus XX or 44 plus XY. Okay, then males are heterogametic, producing, what are the gametes? Produce gametes, X plus, A plus X. And A plus Y. The sperms may be gynosperm or androsperm. Okay, the sperm with Y chromosome are androsperm. Sperm with X chromosome are gynosperm. And females are homogametic because they have homomorphic chromosomes. Sex chromosomes are homomorphic. Okay. And gametes are similar type of gametes, that is A plus X or A plus X or gametes. X or A plus X only. Okay. Then we will do the cross. So the female 44 plus XX. Male 44 plus XY. Put a cross over here. Do not forget this. Here, parents. Okay. Then, take out the gametes. 22 plus X. 22 plus X. Here 22 plus X, 22 plus Y. Okay, directly you will write down the, by taking the number of chromosomes, autosomes, specific number of autosomes you will put over here. Here you will write down gametes. Then, when the egg is fertilized by, what is this? Gynosperm. Then a female is developed. If this is the genotype, then it is a female. And if the egg is fertilized by a androsperm, then the offspring will be male. So these are the offsprings. Okay. So here, which gamete determines the sex of the offspring? Yes. The sex of the offspring is determined by sex of the offspring is determined by the kind of sperm, by the kind of sperm. Okay, this much you have to write down. And ratio is 50-50. Male and female ratio. Male and female ratio. Is 50:50. Not so important, it is understood, but you can write down that. And this is very, very, very important. Do not forget. Parents, write writing of gametes, of strings, putting the cross, whether you are writing of this female, male, like this or not. These are very much important. I told you that in genetics you can score the 100% marks. Okay? But do not forget, you have to write down the points. First of all, I have written in brief. What you will write down? Males are heterogametic because they have the two heteromorphic sex chromosomes X and Y. Males produce two type of gametes, that are two type of sperms, that is A plus X and A plus Y. In the bracket you can write down gynosperm, androsperm. Then females are homogametic, having the two homomorphic sex chromosomes and produce only one type of egg, that is A plus X, and then you will do the cross like this. Single gene effect. What we discussed in the previous session? Then, SRI gene present in the non-homologous region of the Y chromosome, which is not homologous to the X chromosome, in that region, in the male specific region. Single gene effect. Which single gene affect the sex of the human individual? That SRI gene. SRI gene present on the SRI gene, that is sex determining region Y. SRI gene. Sex determining region Y. SRI gene is present on Y chromosome that encodes for TDA that regulates the development of testicular development. Okay, so what it establishes? It develops the testis, and if the testis is developed, then what happens? The Leydig cells, Sertoli cells are that form. The Sertoli cells secrete AMH, anti-Müllerian hormone. Whereas the Leydig cells secrete cells testosterone. Female. What is normal female? Normal female is 44 plus XX with SRI gene. Which SRI gene becomes sterile male? Becomes sterile male when a normal male with 44 plus XY genotype without SRI gene, it becomes sterile female. Okay, like this you have to write down. This much. If it is asked, if you are being asked sex determination in human, then you will write down the sex reversal also. How we will mention sex reversal? In sex reversal, if artificial removal of the gonads takes place before the puberty, that is castration. Castration, again two types you can write, you have to write down within the bracket. You can write down that orchidectomy or ovarectomy. Then the secondary sexual characteristics of the opposite sex develops. This is all. Sex reversal is also seen in the human being, that if the artificial removal of the gonads before puberty occurs, then takes place, then the secondary sexual characteristics of the opposite sex are developed. Okay, the inhuman, the sex determination in human is over. Sex determination in Drosophila. In this, you have to explain XXY mechanism, genic balance mechanism, gynandromorph, and single gene effect. XXY mechanism. In this, again, the same way you have to represent, you have to write down the males. Males are heterogametic. Okay. Males are heterogametic because they have two heteromorphic sex chromosomes, produces two type of gametes. Females are homogametic, is it? Females are homogametic, have homomorphic sex chromosomes and produces one type of gamete. Here the female with 6 plus XX chromosomes, specific, what is the number? 6 autosomes. Male with 6 plus XY, then what are the gametes? 3 plus X, 3 plus X and 3 plus X. This is 3 plus X and 3 plus Y. Sperms are two types. X are one type. 6 plus XX or then egg fertilized by an androsperm, then it is 6 plus XY, it develops into male, it develops into female. Okay, and here you will write down parents, gametes, offspring. Okay, this much you have to write down, and at the end, the type of sperm determines the sex of the offspring. You have to write down the type of sperm determines the sex of the offspring. Okay, genic balance mechanism or genic balance theory was proposed by Calvin Bridges in 1926. This theory states that the ratio in between the number of X chromosome and the number of haploid set of autosomes determines the sex of the offspring. Genic balance or the ratio. So, you have to mention at least the common ones and the common genotypes you have to write down. Here, the chromosomal complement. Ratio. Sex index ratio. X by A. Then the sex of the offspring. Okay. Suppose the genotype is 2A, 2X. So 2 by 2 equal to 1, that means normal female, normal female. Okay, if it is two a plus three x, then 3/2 equal to 1.5, that means super or meta female. Then if the ratio is equal to 1/2 equal to 0.5, then the normal male. Normal means diploid, okay? Diploid male, female. Then if it is 3AAA, means 3 set of autosomes plus XY, that equal to 1/3 equal to 0.33, then super male. You have to write down in word, okay? I am using the symbols over here. If the genotype chromosome complement is three set of autosomes plus, suppose 2x, or simply x only, no y, simply 2x chromosomes, then also 2/3 equal to 0.666, so we can take 0.67, that means intersex. Even it is there that 3a plus 3x, 4a plus 4x, means a normal diploid. How it is a diploid female, like that triploid female, tetraploid female. At least these 5 examples you have to give. Okay. Then gynandromorph. What is gynandromorph? Gynandromorph means, as we have studied, as we have gone through, what is that? When the animal is exhibiting both male and female tissue, male and female characters. It occurs due to the non-disjunction of X chromosome at cleavage. This is a, what you will write down here? This is due to, exhibit both male and female characters. Okay, female characters due to it is due to white occurs due to non-disjunction of X chromosome. Okay, then what is single gene effect in Drosophila? Single gene effect in Drosophila is the transformer gene. The transformer gene present in third autosome. Is it? Third autosome. It has two forms, tra plus dominant and tra. The female, normal female, is it 6 plus XX in homozygous condition. Tra, this is homozygous condition. Then, the normal female converts into sterile male. The female genotype with homozygous dominant or heterozygous when the transformer gene is in a homozygous dominant or heterozygous condition, it has no effect. Even the homozygous recessive in case of male has no effect. It has no effect in males. Males develop normally. But females are converted into the sterile male. Next, which animal? Then birds. Sex determination in birds. Let us take the example of a hen. Hen and cock. Okay. Chicken. In chicken. We will study in chicken. The chromosome complement is 2N equal to 78. That means 76 plus ZW or 76 plus ZZ. So in this mechanism, what happens? The female is having 76 plus ZW or the male is having 76 plus ZZ. Okay. So this is the female. Female heterogamy is seen. Male. The what are the gametes? Female gametes are two types. 38 plus Z or 38 plus W. Whereas male gametes are similar type. 38 plus Z, 38 plus Z. When this type of egg with 76 plus ZZ develops into male. If the egg containing W chromosome fertilized by the sperm, then 76 plus ZW develops into female. Here what you will write down? Here you will write down the parents' gametes and here offspring. Here at the end what you will write down? In the beginning you have to write down females are heterogamety because they have two heteromorphic sex chromosomes and produce two type of eggs, two type of gametes or two type of eggs, that is A plus Z and A plus W. That means here in the case 38 plus Z and 38 plus W. Whereas the males are homogamety, having the homomorphic sex chromosomes, so develops a similar type of gametes. At the end, you will write down the sex of the individual depends upon the sex of the offspring depends upon the type of egg is fertilized. Type of the egg is fertilized. Okay. Another, the sex reversal. When sex reversal? If the, as we know, the birds are having only one functional ovary, that is left functional ovary, right ovary is rudimentary stage. Due to some reason, if the functional ovary is damaged or removed, then the rudimentary ovary develops into a testis and that testis starts secreting the androgen. So, the secondary sex characters of the cock is developed. Here you can write on female, male means what you will write on? The female is hen, male is cock. You can write down like this. Okay. In the specific one, you can write down like this. So, here in the sex reversal, what you will write down? If the functional ovary is damaged, functional ovary is damaged or removed. Is damaged or removed. Rudimentary ovary develops into testis. Testis secreting the androgens and developing the secondary sex characters of cock. Okay, this is all. Then let us discuss the sex determination in honeybees. Sex determination in honeybee is the haplodiploidy mechanism. What is the type of sex determination? Haplodiploidy mechanism means here the ploidy of the organism that determines the sex of the individual. If it is diploid, the female. If it is haploid, it is male. So first of all, what you will write down? Honeybees are having three castes. What are they? The queen, worker, and drone. Okay, so drones are haploid. These are females are diploid. Okay, the queen is fertile, worker is sterile, male is drone is fertile. Two type of females are here. Here you will write down the drone. First you will write down that in honeybee which type of sex determination is found. Okay, haplodiploidy mechanism. Then you will write down it. The honeybees are living in a colony having the three castes, and like this all the these details. Then drone means male bee, queen means female bee, equal here n equal to 16, 2n equal to 32. Okay, these are diploid and these are the parents. By mitosis, drones develop sperms. Okay, and only this is for, whereas by meiosis, queen develops, this is by meiosis, queen develops the two haploid eggs, means queen develops haploid eggs. When fertilization occurs, the diploid female larva is developed. This is female larva. If it is fed with royal jelly, then it develops into queen. If simply it is fed with nectar, then develops into worker. Is it? And in other hand, if it is not fertilized, if this egg is not fertilized, okay, no fertilization, and here through parthenogenesis, the haploid egg develops into the drone. Haploid drone, the male bee. Okay, here what is this? This is the larva. These are offspring. These are the gametes. okay? Here, do not forget to write down mitosis, meiosis, here fertilization, no fertilization, that is through parthenogenesis, if fed with royal jelly, then develops into queen. If fed with simply nectar, it is developing into the worker. The larva develops into worker. Okay, this is all you have to write down for the sex determination in honeybees. If you are being asked for any other animal, like when you will be asked for the reptiles, what you will write down? Sex determination in reptiles along with the other animals. Okay, then you will mention this ZWZZ mechanism as well as the temperature dependent of the environmental. How it is explained for the turtles and lizard and crocodile. If it is asked for the Bonellia, sex determination in Bonellia viridis, simply Bonellia or the marine worm, then you have to mention that how the chemotactic sex determination in Bonellia viridis. Okay, because of the secretion of the bonellin, the secretion of the chemical bonellin, the larva are being attracted and they are settled into the proboscis and develops into the male, rudimentary male. If they are the larvae are settled in the sea floor without any gravid female, mature female, then they again develops into a female. Into the females. Okay, see, like this, how it is asked, of which animal is asked, you have to answer animal wise, completely animal wise, whatever the types you are being taught, that you have to mention. Okay, do the practice of this long question. Okay, thank you.